Russian ambassador gunned down live on television in Turkey, the horrific attack on a Christmas market in Berlin, and a shooting outside of a Islamic center in Switzerland. So how do we stop terrorists before they strike? Dr. Zahoudi Jasser is here next. And caught up people gathered to celebrate Christmas there.
Well, it's obvious to those of us who've been working for reform for decades that the problem is not the final step where they go operational. You just can't predict it. That's why on Dabiq magazine, Ramiya magazine, the magazine for ISIS, they tell them to find soft targets, to use non-conventional weapons like vehicles and knives and things, because they want that moment of surprise where they attack Christians, Jews, and other targets of the religious war. So how do you find this? You shift the axis of discussion in this country on security from violent extremism to violent Islamism. It's the global jihad stupid should be our mantra. These are jihadis before they become militant jihadis. They're non-militant jihadis who believe America's evil, who are against democracy, who believe in the Sharia state, who are misogynistic. They're anti-Christian and anti-Semitic online. And I guarantee you, we are not following those ideas online. So therefore, these guys come out of nowhere once we try to find them to be violent, which is often impossible to predict.
Doctor, that terrible attack in Berlin comes as well when there was an assassination in Turkey of the Russian ambassador. Off-duty officer yelling Allahu Akbar, pulls out his pistol, and it's all over the cover of the New York Post. Steve's holding it up right now, as well as covers across the country. Yells Allahu Akbar and shoots him in the back, assassinating him, trying to fracture even further relations between Turkey and Russia, which were difficult and have thawed. But it's the same strand of jihad at some level. Should they have seen that coming? How do we anticipate those types of things?
Well, again, who are our friends and who are our allies? If he's from the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, like the killer in Berlin, they're from an Islamic State concept. If they're members of the AKP in Turkey and believe in Islamist state mantra and are against Western ideas, against Russia, against, you know, countries that are not Islamist, they're not going to be our friends. I mean, the AKP yesterday tweeted out that this man was a martyr. Remember, the AKP is the party of Erdogan. Yeah. They're very upset that Erdogan was reaching out to Russia and Iran in order to maintain that dictator club in the Middle East. So therefore, it's not just about who our enemies are. The enemies of our enemies are not always our friends. And if they're fighting for freedom in Syria, like our family and others, those are probably our allies. But if they're fighting for jihad, for an Islamic state, for Islamic supremacism across the Middle East, those are our enemies. And we have to be careful not to say, well, Erdogan today is our friend, but he still is the head of an AKP party that is radicalizing his population.
Dr. Jasser, the State Department issued a warning to Americans. They said that this happened 3 weeks ago. The Department of State alerts U.S. citizens to the heightened risk of terrorist attacks throughout Europe, particularly during the holiday season. U.S. citizens should exercise caution at holiday festivals, events, and outdoor markets. How did they know that something like this, were there warnings that they were seeing, and that was their way of warning all of us to be very careful and vigilant?
Well, here's the thing. There's two areas to look at. One is specifically this individual. We have to leave it to Homeland Security to monitor his ideas, his websites that he's looking at. If it's ideologically, we should be looking at that public footprint. Publicly, we cannot let these chaotic Islamists win by unraveling our fabric of society and who we are. Israel's been dealing with this for decades, and they haven't changed their public celebrations and other things, but they're vigilant. If they see something, they say something. Yeah. Look at, don't always just be staring at your cell phone. Look around at your surroundings. Make sure that you are aware of the fact that anything can become a weapon in a public place.
Well, if they knew
Sadly, especially this time of year.
If they knew about it, why did this happen?
Because the enemy to them is anyone who's just violent. This mm-hmm. guy probably never projected that he was going to do something violent. If the enemy was Islamist, global jihadism, Salafism, like San Bernardino or Orlando, those are all Salafi jihadists, I bet you it would have been on their radar and they would have been able to do something about
it. The other component to it, Dr. Jasser, is the fact that this guy who shot the ambassador is a cop.
Know.
You know, he's a guy who was supposed to have a gun. They just didn't realize that as he was standing behind the ambassador, he was going to start yelling Allahu Akbar and then kill the ambassador. I mean, our important people are protected by officers all the time, guys with guns, and you just don't know when somebody like this nitwit's going to just, you know, go crazy.
And And we saw this in the Cold War. So many of the infiltrators working for the Soviets against us were within our security apparatus. Islamists are within it. The Orlando shooter was a security guard. Many of these folks already have clearances that are working within, but they hate the country that they're in because they're Islamists who don't believe in our contract of society based in secular liberalism, which is the war that we're fighting.
Ultimately, Doctor, you're talking about allegiance. If there's no allegiance to the country you're in, you're just in that country. Well, thank you very much for providing a lot of clarity for us this morning. Dr. Zudi Jasser, thank you.